You might be surprised to learn that this scene is taking place in Everglades National Park. Everglades National Park was established in 1947 to protect and preserve the biodiversity found in this amazing and unique ecosystem. And what is happening here, and a part of the park called the Hole in the Donut, is actually working towards that goal. This area gets its name because it was used for agriculture and was farmed even after the park was established. When farming ended in 1975, there remained thousands of acres of disturbed soil in the heart of, and surrounded by, the native habitats of the Everglades. In this disturbed environment, invasive species proliferated. Invasive species are plants or animals that are not native to an ecosystem but are introduced there by humans. People might release them into the new ecosystem on purpose or by accident. But once there, they thrive and end up causing problems for our native species and for us. When people think of invasive species, they tend to picture large, hair-raising animals like Burmese pythons. But invasive species, unfortunately, come in many shapes and sizes. And the one causing the most harm in the Hole in the Donut? Brazilian pepper. Brazilian pepper is from South America and was brought here as an ornamental plant because people found its bright red berries and brilliant green foliage beautiful. Brazilian pepper grew quickly in the disturbed soil of the Hole in the Donut, growing tall and dense, forming an impenetrable tangle of branches and a canopy so thick that other plants could not grow in its understory. It outcompeted native vegetation for resources and soon grew in a vast monoculture across the landscape. Which brings us back here. Since 1997, the Hole in the Donut has been the site of a large-scale restoration project. Simply removing the plants wouldn't work, because farmers needed to use techniques such as rock plowing and fertilization to grow crops in the area, the soil was so changed from its original state that Brazilian pepper would grow right back. The solution? Completely removing the substrate and scraping away the soil all the way down to the limestone bedrock. It's a lot of work, but it is working. Once conditions that allow the Brazilian pepper to outcompete the native plants are removed, native species return. Within the first year, grasses grow in the lower and therefore wetter marl prairies. And at naturally higher and drier points, given enough time, pine trees emerge. Wildlife, such as wading birds and deer, return to the area, foraging for food and leaving seeds behind in their waste, helping to reestablish native vegetation. Human-made alterations to the Everglades ecosystem have caused big changes with big consequences. But the Hole in the Donut restoration shows us that if we let them be, the Everglades and the natural world itself are resilient.